Hello, this is a general what do you need to know reading for my lovely Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. You can also check your 7th house and your North Node placement. This reading is going to be focused on love, but allow this to apply to you in the way that it does. If it applies, that's awesome, and if it doesn't apply, let it fly, and we're going to dive right into your reading. I already pre-shuffled, and I'm going to also pull some other cards as well. So the first card out that we have here is the Nine of Cups, which is wish fulfillment. It's somebody that is striving towards their goals, and also it could be that you're overindulging in the things that you love. So that is beautiful energy to begin with. Nine is also the number of completion numerology wise. So I see that there is a person here. This is crossing energy. There is somebody who is stalking or keeping a close eye on you. So what you need to know, my beautiful Aries, is that there is wish fulfillment coming your way. All right. There is somebody who's investigating or looking into you. This person is being enlightened, right? You see they're investigating, they're watching, and they're also being enlightened. This energy is very similar here. This person is someone who may have Earth in their chart. So this could be a Taurus, a Capricorn, or even a Virgo. With this Queen of Pentacles crossing as well. This woman here is financially stable, or this individual here is financially stable. They're confident in what they do, they're nurturing, and they're very grounded. All right, I see that you're finding clarity on what path that you need to know with this Two of Swords here. I see that you're finding clarity, okay, because this came crossing, but for me in the crossing in the reversal, okay? So I see that you're becoming more clear on what path to take and which way to go. And I see with the Judgment card, you're becoming more clear when it comes to resurrecting situations. So maybe you are finding wish fulfillment because you decided to move away from things that clouded your judgment, okay? Clouded your sense of direction, all right? And you're starting to resurrect or overindulge in what you love by going from within. So that is beautiful, all right? So numerology wise, we got two twos, okay, with the Two of Swords and the 20 card for Judgment. So that shows me that you're building towards something, all right? Energy wise, crossing in the upright, we have the Envy card, number 20. So we have two 20s. So 2020 can be a very important year for you. It could be a year where you started to learn what direction you want to go into. You started to learn what you really want to focus your energy and build on, right? So with this Envy card, rather you're envious towards someone, but I'm getting clairaudiently that this is somebody who is envious towards you. Somebody's envious towards what you're building on, okay? What you're creating for yourself, which is wish fulfillment, all right? I see that you are entering a place with this man holding a heart energetically where you are being more emotionally fulfilled by what you're doing. All right, so we got, yeah, mentally, because we have two cards here which signifies your mental, the way you think, the way you're perceiving things, your logic. I see that you're becoming more clear on that, all right? We got two cards that's signifying your logic, your mental, the air element, right? And we have the Judgment, which is for me as a reader, the Libra. So actually there's three cards. That's three cards here, and three's root number is 9, and you got wish fulfillment, emotional wish fulfillment. So somebody could be envious towards the partner that you've attracted, or someone is envious because you are emotionally fulfilled in the way that you want to be. Okay? This is focused on love, but I'm getting a very general reading for you, Aries. So maybe you guys need a more general reading, okay? So again, let this apply to you in the way that it does. Romantically, I see that you're becoming more clear on who you want, and you could have found somebody that is nurturing towards you, or someone that you're nurturing towards. Now, this Queen of Pentacles can also be a child. It could be a birth. Rather, that's a furry child, you know, a pet. Rather, you're an animal mother or an animal father, or a physical mother and father with a human, right? This is somebody who is embracing nature and also embracing Mother Nature within themselves, all right? With the children or the family that they create as well. When I get the Queen of Pentacles, to me, she signifies like Mother Earth. So at the bottom of the deck, we have the Strength in Reverse, which is the Leo card. So you could very much so be dealing with the Leo. But in reverse, it shows me that the root was that you were feeling like you had to compete for something. You felt there was some type of conflict, could have been a conflict with a Leo. If it's not a conflict with a Leo, it could be that you were having some issues with finding that inner child, being more playful. You're feeling kind of like you didn't have the courage to do what you felt you wanted to do passionately, because there was a lot of energy where you felt you had to compete. All right, you had to compete in order to be noticed. But it's showing me that with the Sun card here, we have the number 19 card, the Sun card, which signifies ultimate happiness, a fresh start, a new beginning. Again, the Sun card is the star, so you could have Aquarius in your chart, or the Sun card could also, it is for me, the Leo card, but as a reader, it can also signify the Aquarius card, because Sun is the star, which is wish fulfillment, the higher form of the Nine of Cups. That's the major arcana of the Nine of Cups for me as a reader. I see love-wise, with the Love Oracle, there is some communication that's coming in. Again, with this Page of Swords energy, this is communication coming in. So this could be somebody that you're talking to on social media, somebody that you're communicating with online, or this could be that you're communicating with somebody every day. And this is someone that you are interested in having a union with, or this person is interested in having a union with you. And this could be someone who is a dark male, or you could be a dark male. However, if you are not, you know, melanated, you could be darker than your partner, like a more olivey skin color, or your partner could have a more olivey skin color. So let those specifics resonate with the person that it's supposed to. These cards are very specific, so it may not resonate with everybody. So the naked truth, what you need to know is that you have to find sight with this Potion of Sight, with this Impede card. You have to realize that anything that's making you feel constricted or tied down, that you have to take off those blindfolds, right? And invoke what it is that you want, okay? So you can start by petitioning, which is applying for what you want energetically. Asking for what it is that you want from the universe, right? Ask and you shall receive. So ask and bring forth, right here is what it's telling you. We have the dandelion, so call forth divination. So if you work with pendulums, work with a pendulum. If you free write, free write. If you're someone who actually makes music, make music. Do what you feel is going to invoke the highest frequency within yourself, okay? We also have cinnamon, which is rising your vibration, and telephone call desire. So again, with this communication, here it is, she's holding a telephone. Now we have two telephones. So if it is something that you want to call upon, even if it's physically calling someone, do so. And the potion here for invoke is your heart space. Now we had that Leo energy, right, twice with the Sun and the Strength card, and Leo rules the heart. So working on that heart space is so significant for you at this time. And here it is with the Nine of Cups. We also got this Strive card. So strive towards what it is that you want to succeed with. You see, they're both striving towards what they want to achieve, right? So go on this quest to pursue whatever it is that you need to, all right? And the potion is motivation. You are a fire sign. You are ruled by Mars. So take action on what it is that you want. Be fearless when you do so. And once you do that, you will see the peak of that mountain and you will achieve that goal, okay? With this trophy, which is end results of success, which I saw wish fulfillment, and underlying all of this feelings of like you have to compete or you can't be strong enough, you're going to find the ultimate happiness, okay? Once you let go of this fear, I see that you have fear here, so you need to calm down the anxieties that you're feeling, all right? And you have to soothe out the situations that you are feeling fearful towards. And this is going to bring forth a lot of clarity for you, a lot of balance. Oh, wow, and the potion is balance. And remember, the Judgment card I said is Libra. And Libra signifies the scales, so they bring forth a lot of balance and clarity for us. So in reverse with the Love and Romance card, we have chemistry in reverse. So there's a strong magnetic attraction here. So you could be feeling with this Strength card in reverse that you're not having the attraction or you're not having the chemistry with this individual that you're connecting with. And it could be due to children. It could be you wanting to have children and your partner does not. Oh, wow. And at the bottom of the deck of the Naked Truth is Source. So again, it could be that you want to plan a pregnancy or your partner wanted a pregnancy and you guys are having some type of miscommunication when it comes to what you guys want when it comes to building a family. But it's telling you here that you have to sprout whatever you want, okay? Tend to whatever you want to grow. And the potion is tend and protect, all right? Fertility is something that is signified by the herb sage. So you might need to start saging your energy, start resetting your energy in your homes. Okay, so children underlying the bottom of the deck of these two with the Naked Truth and the Romance Angels. You know, you have to learn that your love life is being affected by children in some sort of way. Okay, let that apply to who it's supposed to apply to. And at the bottom of the deck of the energy reading, we have the Angel of Love. Self-love or love with the individual that you are involved with. All right, so let's get a numerology card out here with the playing cards, Two of Wands here. So Two of Spades, which is also the Two of Wands. So making a clear decision on what it is that you want to indulge in and moving forward towards that fearlessly, okay? That, to me, goes hand in hand with this Strive card. Going towards whatever it is that you want and not second-guessing yourself with this fear, not letting that stop you. And this is what you need to know. So when it comes to love, you need to not let any type of envy discourage you. You need to know that you are going to find that divine counterpart, whether you're a masculine looking for a feminine and you're looking for this heart here, or you're a feminine looking for this masculine with a heart. You have the Angel of Love, and this is what you need to know. You need to know that there is nothing that can discourage you and make you feel like you have to compete with this happiness that's coming and that this happiness that's sitting in your energy. You have nothing but wish fulfillment. You have passionate messages coming into you that's going to bring a lot of stability, okay? Once you learn to find that clarity on what direction to go by using your higher judgment, you're going to enter a place where you can find union, clear communication, okay? And whatever miscommunications you're having with children, you need to choose if it's something that you can compromise. All right, so I hope this is helpful. If you would like to book a personal reading with me, please don't hesitate to contact me at LadyPavoTV, and that's on Instagram, where I have my personal tarot reading menu. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment, and also hit the bell notification down below so you can get notified for when I post new videos. I really enjoy doing this reading with you. We are divinely connected. Until next time, peace.